Are you still training Shawn Rhoden right now?
No, I haven't spoken to Shawn, and we spoke briefly through internet, but Instagram, but we haven't spoken in years.
Why did you guys split up?
I don't know. We never had a conversation about it, but I know that there were a lot of people involved with me getting removed from goals, and I think he was one of them.
Wow. So let's take a step back for a second. So 2018 is when he won, right? That's when you guys won the Olympia. So talk about that prep. You know, what did you guys do differently for him to win? Because prior to that, he had a jaw broken, right? He placed fifth, and you know, and obviously he went against Phil Heath. He beat Phil on the stage. So what were the key elements that you implemented that made him a champion?
Now, when he took fifth, not only did he have a broken jaw, he also had ulcers that he had to have emergency surgery with. And still,
I heard about that. I heard about the ulcers, yeah.
Right. That was true. Some people think that was fake. That was actually true. He actually had several blood transfusions, and he actually had internal bleeding. He actually could have died. He came back from those two things, the ulcers, to actually take fifth in the world. So I knew we were on to something. And it basically was just training like it was 1973. It was just very few machines and just every day try to deplete, take everything out of him. And Chris Aceto would adjust the protocol and adjust the diet daily. So basically, it wasn't that hard. It was basically just push him extremely hard, which he wasn't done before. So when I first acquired Dexter and I first acquired Shawn, I did an interview with Dave Berlay. And I said, he is going to beat Phil. This was 2017. I said, he's going to beat. And everybody was like, oh my God, how can you say that? I said, Shawn was never trained to beat Phil. He was never trained to beat Phil. He was always trained for second. He was trained for third. He was trained for not, that's not how, so you understand, I was around the best in the world. I know what top tier training is. And what Shawn was doing wasn't that. Nothing against Charles, nothing against anybody else, just what I saw these greats do, that wasn't it. So I knew if I turned the switch and really pushed Shawn, I knew he would win it, and I trusted Chris Aceto to do his part, so it was pretty easy for him to win the Mr. Olympia contest. And also, people often do this. So this is something that maybe your young viewers, and this is something even top bodybuilders should understand. It's a bodybuilding show, but not really. Really, it's a talent contest. So what people do with Phil, what they did with Dorian, what they did with Ronnie, they always try to beat Ronnie, or they try to beat Dorian, or they try to beat Phil. It's not a competition of you and Phil. See, Shawn didn't beat Phil. Shawn beat himself. Phil didn't beat his Phil. Phil lost to himself. That wasn't Phil's best look. That was Shawn's best look. Judges want to see change. If it's a talent show and you're a singer, why would you get up there and try to rap? If you're a rapper, why be a singer? So they were trying to get Shawn bigger and bigger and bigger when his strength is what? Symmetry, hardness. Don't copy Phil. Beat Shawn. And that's how he won. Phil was actually bamboozled. I knew exactly what he was going to do. I knew how he was going to look. And Phil's nickname is Mr. Saturday Night. So Haney, his trainer, pumps him up even more with more carbs, and he extends his gut even more. So instead of us going bigger to catch up with Phil, something we never could do, why don't we pull down and not make it an arm contest? Make it a good posing contest. Don't make it a most muscular. Make it an ab contest. Make it a quad contest. And that's why Shawn won. Shawn was the best Shawn you had ever seen, and Phil was one of the worst Phils you had ever seen. That's why. When you can't win the argument, change the argument.
Well, Phil actually made an argument after he lost that he considered that he beat him in every pose. The back, the side, the chest, everything, except for the stomach, where he had a hernia surgery, or he is dealing with that issue, and that's what he believes that's what made him lose. When you hear that statement that he said he beat him in every mandatory pose, you don't agree with that?
Maybe he did beat him in every pose. Maybe he did. But when you leave it up to the judges, you have Mr. Olympia. He doesn't beat you in every pose. He smashes you in every poses. When Ronnie, he smashed his competition. Jay, he smashed his competition. You can't beat them. You have to smash them. Just like boxing. You have to knock the champ out. You have to knock him out. So he may have beat Sean, but did Phil beat Phil? No, that wasn't the best Phil. That was the best Sean. So therefore, you lose.
Did you know after Friday prejudging that Sean was going to win?
I knew 10 weeks before we walked on the stage he was going to lose. Right. I actually made a live video telling everybody after prejudging, you could feel it in the air that Sean had won. So the question was this. He won. So a lot of people, there's been a lot of controversial decisions, but a lot of controversial decisions. But thing is like this, will they give it to him? Sean was so far ahead. The crowd was so hyped. Phil lost his composure. And I knew what Haney was going to do. He was going to extend that gut even more. But it's worked before for them. It's worked 1,000. It worked 7 times. So let's pump him up. Let's get him bigger. And let's do a lot of most musculars and pump the crowd up. So I told Sean, when he goes into that most muscular, don't do it. There's no way you're going to beat him in a most muscular. When he does that, stand back and look at him like he's a child. And that's when Phil fell apart. Actually, Phil was bamboozled. He was bamboozled. He was out-conditioned, but more than that, Sean commanded the stage. He let you know he was the star attraction, and everyone felt it, and everyone believed it, and he won. The only person that didn't believe it was Phil, because he's saying, I did everything right. My arm is better, my leg is better, but your package isn't better because you didn't beat Phil. That's what you have to tell. You have to beat yourself in these shows. You're only as good as your last presentation.
Right. That's interesting. I mean, Phil told me that basically after the Friday night, they told him that, you know, he heard from somebody. Somebody told Haney or the judges or something like that mm-hmm. you know, he's going, that Sean is probably going to win. So he had that already on Saturday on his mind, that he's a big chance of him losing, actually.
Right, and probably that affected his condition even more. You never tell anybody that. If you guys go back and replay it, you can see Phil came out with defeat all over his body. He came out with desperation. He's trying to pump the crowd. He's trying to amp up. Sean came out there like, I won. I know I won. Let's just get the formalities over with so I can go home.
So how soon after the victory, obviously it was a great moment in your career and his career, you know, it's a great, you know, obviously he defeated a champion, Phil, you know, many regarded him as an unbeatable champion, you know, to be honest with you. Phil was so dominant for so many years. But how soon after the victory did you and Sean had your fallout, basically?
Well, we never had a fallout. We never had an argument. We had a discussion over payment. Because you understand, I'm a guru that I believe in getting paid. And I had heard that Sean wasn't going to come back to me next year. Wasn't upset about it, but Sean started kind of dissing himself from me right after the show. I mean, right after. We had lunch. Months went by. I asked him about payment. He paid me what I asked for. I don't think he really wanted to, but that's just my opinion. We went on tour, and we didn't say 3 words to each other all on tour. So I pretty much knew that I wouldn't be training him anymore.
And then he went back to Charles Glass?
No. What I've heard from one of the people, that they had already had a plan, even before Sean won, for he was going to go back to Charles. That him and Dexter was going to go back to Charles. I got a whiff of that before.
But it's confusing to me because why change the winning formula? Because Charles trained him before, right? He didn't win the Olympia with Charles. I'm just saying, I'm not trying to disrespect Charles. What I'm saying is why change the winning formula? You know what I mean? I don't understand.
Men fight over one or two things. What do they fight over? What are wars waged over? One or two things. It's money and women. We weren't competing for women. So it had to be money. Maybe if I wouldn't request the payment, maybe I still would be there. But I lost a lot of respect for, because I always thought Shawn was a really intelligent person. And just like you said, most top bodybuilders, they would have won the show that no one thought they could win. They wouldn't break the formula. He broke the formula. I don't think that was very intelligent. I just don't think that was really smart.
Did you ever confront him about it? Like, what's happening?
Why? No, that guy can go, he can have anybody train him, whoever, whenever he wants to. He wants to go another route. He wants to go back to Charles, let him do that. But then every day that goes by and I don't see him beating the condition that we put together, I lose more respect for him. So if Shawn came to me today and asked me to train him, I wouldn't. Because I think that was dumb to even leave in the first place.